So a lot of changes have taken place which we have witnessed from near but also from far. When Mao and the Communist Party liberated China, China became a free country. Then 1978, Chairman Deng Xiaoping had a very clever way of how to combine capitalism and socialism. And how to combine internal and the external and take advantage of the huge size of China in terms of manpower to modernize China. Big changes, because at that time the economy of China was still smaller than, for instance, countries like England. Now it's the second biggest economy in the world. So definitely a lot of changes which I have seen. In the 1960s, if you took the picture of Beijing, you would see a lot of bicycles. I think the vehicles were fewer on the road. Now the streets are full of vehicles. A lot of changes have also taken place in Africa, but Africa does not have the advantage of China of being governed together, because first of all, the problem of Africa is integration. China was already integrated. Big country, 1.3 billion people, under one political command. Africa is scattered. But we had already seen this, and we are working on it, on integration. Then we can add on the example of China, how they used opening up. But infrastructure, for instance, that's a good example from China. Concentrating on infrastructure. That one is for sure a good example. We are mainly working with China on electricity, the roads, and the railway. When we are doing a road funded by the government of Uganda, we advertise, say, who wants to do this road? European companies come, African companies come, Arab companies come, but the Chinese, by working on the roads, they are opening up the country, making transport easier. The railway is the one which is good for business, because it transports goods cheaply.